YouTube, welcome to Cafe No Man. Welcome to our reaction to Free. We are going to react to the song My Brother Jake. This is our first time listening to the song My Brother Jake.
Okay.
Yeah.
Clapping for them at the end.
Maybe. This
musical style of this reminded me a lot of Elton John for some reason. You
this
know?
Is kind of jazzy too.
Yeah. It reminded me a lot of Elton John. If Elton John sung this, I would have probably loved it 10 times more.
Yeah,
to be honest. I liked it. It was a decent song. I won't get too much into the specifics of why I like it. I'll leave that for Kirti to see, to share with you. That's what matters more for our channel and for all of us. Let's see what she thinks of it.
I liked it. There was something about it. There was more concern in the voice, the way it was sung. And I found that good. It felt like he's actually singing for his younger brother. Maybe not called Jake, maybe something else. But My Brother Jake, I like the title itself, the way it is sung. The way it's kind of dedicated to a younger brother who's maybe not on the right path. It felt like his brother is an addict, to be honest. So he's trying to, you know, talk to him in a very nice way. Generally, people lose their mind. Generally, people, you know, get fed up of people in the family like that. People don't want to have anything to do with them. They ignore them. They try to get away from them. They just would want them to vanish or disappear so that their lives would not be miserable. But here is a brother who's saying, you know, you can do things differently. You could make things better. You could change your life. You could change the people around you too. You could have a new start once more. And this kind of music is required. This kind of more music should have been made, where musicians were actually going out appealing to people this way, as if you are my family member. This would be a dedication to all of those young children, all of those young kids who are slipping into the wrong habits. But what I mean, I don't know much about Free too, what the band members did in their personal life. But you're never sure, because it was the band members themselves and almost all of the bands that had all of the vices that they were singing about. And most of them didn't even touch these topics because, you know, it would be hypocritical for them to even sing about it. So I like Free doing it, My Brother Jake, in such a wonderful way.
Yeah, most of the artists that we listen to are fortunately, unfortunately from America, UK, America and UK probably make up 90 to 95% of the requests we've done. And that's a lot of requests that we've done from artists just from two countries. And the situation of these two countries, specifically America, is quite bad. It's quite earth-shattering, the situation right now. They make up around 4% of the world's population.
Yeah.
The population of America today is approximately or roughly 4% of the world's population. But you won't believe how much of the prescription drugs of the world they consume. That 4% of the world's population manages to consume over 70% of the prescription drugs manufactured and sold in a calendar year. 70% of the world's sold prescription drugs, I repeat, are consumed by less than 4% of the world's population. When it comes to drugs by itself, which is usually unprescribed,
illicit,
at least not prescribed by your neighborhood doctor. But sometimes even they, in that part of the world, even the doctors happen to be involved in these drug rackets and mafias. So you can never tell. When it comes to unprescribed or unofficially taking drugs, once again, if rough statistics are to go by, then Colombia doesn't have a chance. You know, the average Westerner, at least the average American, even the average Canadian, manages to consume a lot of drugs in their lifetime. It's a sad situation. So this is one such situation. It was very clear to me the moment it started and the way it went that this guy, whoever they're talking about, is some kind of an addict. And with 4% of the world population consuming more than 70% of the drugs manufactured and sold or grown and sold, there are a lot of people, a lot of Brother Jakes in that part, part of the world.
Jakes.
Yeah, only God can save them. And unfortunately, most of them don't even believe in God. So God has, I guess God has better people to save right now. So it's like a God-forsaken country. And I call it a God-forsaken land, a God-forsaken country. Even some parts of my country are like that.
Yeah.
It is actually true. You know, because you don't believe in God yourself. Why should God believe in you? Or why should God even bother about you? It's as simple as that. Now let's hear what the degenerates, the addicts, the depressed, the suicidal, the retards, the lowlives have to say about all this. I'm sure they have a lot to say. The only trouble is they really can't put it in words too well. Spell checks don't help. Should have paid more attention in school. Oh, you didn't go to school, most of you.